Hey guys, how are you doing? Psycho Boy UK here again. This is a video for some of my followers on Twitter. Basically just going to highlight my Transformers toys collection from the second two films, Dark of the Moon and Revenge of the Fallen. So I'm just going to start off with my Decepticon part of the collection. Basically the collection's actually that big, I can't get it all in one video, so I'm going to have to do it by faction. So we'll start off with my Decepticon group. First off, we have Decepticon Rampage, I think it is. It's a really cool toy. I like the fact that it's a bulldozer, because when you're a kid, you love bulldozers. You think they're brilliant. You want to drive one when you're a kid. You want to take it and destroy your school or destroy your mum and dad's place of work so you can have more time with your parents. But this toy, to be fair, wasn't my favourite, and it's not exactly the most well-built one either. The reason why it looks kind of off-looking is because I lost the instructions for it and I can't actually remember how to transform it, basically. So if anybody can post a link to an instruction sheet or video to help me out, get him back to how he's meant to be in alt mode, that'd be fantastic, that'd be brilliant. Cheers. Next on my hit list is one that I've actually been looking for since the first motion picture came out. I couldn't get one when the first motion picture came out. I couldn't get one for the Dark of the Moon line, or not the Dark of the Moon, Revenge of the Fallen line, because I don't think there was one, to my knowledge anyway. But I got one from the Dark of the Moon line, and I'm so happy I got one. It's my Decepticon Barricade toy. Looks brilliant. It's one of my favourite toys in my collection at the moment. Very well detailed, as you can see. Again, all these toys will be getting a very, very, very detailed individual review over the next few months. But each toy will have their own review. But quickly, it's a really nice looking toy, very well built. You can very barely see the join lines where bits and pieces pop out and stuff. I was expecting a wee bit more from it, but again, it's a toy, so. But it looks cool and it will get its own review in the near future. I highly recommend that one to anybody that's a fan of Barricade or even just the Decepticons in general. Next one I've got here is one I got off a review that Mr. Powerglide did about a month or so ago, maybe a bit longer, which is Decepticon Hatchet. He is part of the Dread unit that the Decepticons have. In the Dark of the Moon film, he's an SUV, but in his toy, he's a plane. I don't know which one. I'm not big on planes. I don't know my planes at all, but he's definitely a plane in his toy mode here. I keep him in his robot mode because he looks awesome and completely badass. So he stays in his robot mode. It's one of few toys at the moment that stay in robot mode. I think there's only two toys that I keep in robot mode at the moment, and this is one of them. And it just looks badass in robot mode. Again, he'll get his own special review when I can get the time to do one. Next on my list is Decepticon Dead End. Now, this is, in effect, just a repaint of Sideways, which you'll see in just a second. As you can see, black, purple windows. If you can't see the purple windows, he's got very purple windows. He's got the red stripes going across his top there. His Decepticon logo there and stuff. I mean, it's a very nice car, very nice toy, very well built. I just wish it could be a little bit better built in some places. The robot mode's not very good either, so I keep these two in particular in their car modes because it's the Audi R8 and it looks awesome. So as I was saying, it's Sideways here. Again, it is effectively just Dead End. It's just the one that you actually see in Revenge of the Fallen. He's got his Decepticon logo on his back there, and again, it's just basically the same car. Again, they could have hidden the joins a bit better where that bit flips up and stuff, and again, the robot mode could have been better, but apart from that, it's a really cool toy because it's an R8, again. Next toy in my Decepticon collection is one I've actually been, again, looking for since the original film, or the original motion picture film anyway, and that's Starscream. I couldn't get one for the original motion picture. I couldn't get one for Love Nor Money for Revenge of the Fallen. It just happened that the shop that I usually get my toys from had a bunch of these in when the Dark of the Moon line came out, and I managed to get one, but it looks awesome and I'm glad I got him. He's looks very well built. There are one or two places where it could have been built a little bit better. I mean, this bit here is not meant to move as easily as that, and I can't get it into these tabs because every time I do it, it just pops out. So there's obviously something wrong with it somewhere. They all have their flaws somewhere or another. Very cool toy. He'll get his own review in the near future. But I love the toy. It looks pretty cool. It's with the Decepticon logo there, which you can see, which is quite cool. Again, very cool toy, and I'm glad I have it. It's one of the prides of my collection. But yeah, he'll get his own review, hopefully in the next few months. Penultimate toy in the Decepticon collection is one which I've just actually received off Mr. Powerglide through a competition which he ran recently, is Commander Class Megatron from Dark of the Moon. Again, I've not had a chance to get hands on with this, so I'm not going to give it any kind of detail, but it does look pretty cool. He sees the Decepticon logo there. Yeah, again, once I get a better hands on, I'll give him a better review, but that's my Megatron one from Dark of the Moon. And my last and final Decepticon toy, this one is the pride of my Decepticon collection, purely because of the fact it's the biggest one I've got, and he looks ultimately badass. It's basically this guy here. I don't think he needs many introductions, but if you do not know him, it's Soundwave. Shockwave. Yeah, Shockwave. Yeah, that's the one. I don't even know. Anyway, this is Shockwave. Two reasons why I bought him. A, because he's purple, and B, because the toy in robot mode looks absolutely kin badass, and I think it's one of my favourite toys in my collection thus far. It stays in robot mode. It has been in vehicle mode once and will never grace vehicle mode possibly ever again. I don't like the vehicle mode. Look, when it's in his tank mode and you've got everything in its place, it looks like there's a big chunk missing, and it just doesn't look good in vehicle mode. So it will stay in robot mode for as long as I can keep it in robot mode. If I ever have kids, they ain't touching these things because they'll end up fucking breaking them. But anyway, again, that's the Decepticon portion of my collection. I will do a separate video for my Autobot collection as soon as this one's uploaded. But if you have any questions or you collect them yourself, please feel free to comment, link me below. My Facebook, my Twitter will all be in the description box. If you want to give me a follow or find me on Facebook, feel free. And I'll see you in my next video, guys. Cheers.